Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. And this is the testimony of John. When the Jews from Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to him to ask him, "Who are you?" he admitted and did not deny it, but admitted, "I am not the Christ." So they asked him, "What are you then? Are you Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." So they said to him, "Who are you, so we can give an answer to those who sent us? What do you have to say to yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as Isaiah the prophet said." Some Pharisees were also sent. They asked him, "Why then do you baptize, if you are not the Christ or Elijah or the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water, but there is one among you who you do not recognize, the one who is coming after me, whose sandal strap I am not worthy to untie." This happened in Bethany across the Jordan, where John was baptized. My dear friends, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Good evening.
Good evening.
Can you greet your companions? Good evening.
Good evening.
Wow. We are already at the third Sunday of Advent. Go there this Sunday. Sunday of rejoicing. Kung tingnan niyo po yung ating tatlong kandila ng mga sinde, this represents the 3 weeks of Advent. Yung katlo, color pink. It is a sign of joyful or rejoicing Sunday. Para sinasabi natin, we are in a long journey, pero sabi natin, malapit na tayo. We are already just around the corner and we are rejoicing. If you are a person waiting, at malapit na inihintay mo, you have all the reason to rejoice. Take note, I am using the word to rejoice. Alam nyo ba, hindi po pareho yung to be happy and to be joyful. Madalas narinig ko sa mga kabataan, mga Pilipino, kung saan ka masaya. As long as you are happy. Did you know na hindi lahat ng masaya ay mabuti? May tawang masaya ng kakasino. May masaya sa mino. May masaya sa misyo. Hindi lahat ng masaya mabuti. That's why we have to distinguish kung ano ang masaya na mabuti. That is our source of rejoicing. Hindi porke tumatawa ka, masaya ka, you are already rejoicing. Hindi lahat ng mga tumatawa talagang masaya. Ano niwala po kayo? Hindi lahat ng mga tumatawa ay talagang masaya. Pumunta man po kayo sa mental hospital. Ang daming tumatawa doon. Hindi ko alam kung talagang masaya sila. Pero, sometimes, a person will not be laughing all the while, all the time, pero malalim ang kanilang kaligayahan. May use the word, kaligayahan. Kaya nga, hindi po pareho yung masaya sa maligaya. Hindi po yung maligaya meaning maligaya sa kaligayahan. What do I mean? Tingnan nyo, how do we greet each other in Filipino, Merry Christmas? Ha? Maligayang Pasko. Hindi man natin sinasabi, masayang Pasko. Tingnan nyo po yung Filipino, how do we greet each other, Happy New Year? Maligaya, bagong taon. Hindi masaya bagong taon. Even our happy birthday, it's not only happy, maligaya, pagsilang. Our sense of rejoicing has something to do with the definition of what is rejoicing compared to only being happy. Marami po talaga yung tao masaya. Pero hindi naman talaga nanggagaling sa malalim na kaligayahan ng ating Ebanghelyo. My dear friends, kung tingnan niyo po, check niyo po yung gospel, no? Meron yung 365 na. All the readings, from the first reading, the responsorial psalm, the second reading, they all have the word rejoice. At saan magagaling ka ng kaligayahan? Hindi man po sa party. Hindi. Saan magagaling ng kaligayahan? Wala ko po kinalaman sa shopping o sa mga bagay na lang bibili natin. Tingnan mo natin kay Isaiah. Look at the joy of Isaiah. It is the joy of Isaiah in celebrating his mission in life. There is rejoicing in mission. Pag may mission ka sa buhay, mayroon kang malalim na kaligayahan. Dahil alam mo ang gagawin mo araw-araw. Mayroon pinupuntahan ang araw mo. Hindi sayang ang oras mo. Hindi sayang ang buhay mo. Pwede yung iba, every day, pwede nagsashopping mo, maybe around the world, many times. But it does not mean meron silang mission. Sigurado lang, meron silang ginagastos. Pero meron ba silang mission sa buhay other than their own happiness? I don't know. Kasi sabi ni Isaiah, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, to release to the prisoners, and announce a year of favor for the Lord and a day of vindication by God." This is the joy of Isaiah. In fact, Jesus in Luke chapter 4, 1-11, quoted this rejoicing vision of Isaiah, that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Ang kaligayahan ng taong may mission. Kaya nga po pagbinyag, other than the holy water, mayroon pong chrism, the oil of anointing. We are anointing to have mission. Pwede kasi mabuting tao ka, mabuti. Mabuti ang tao, walang kasalanan, mabuting intention mo, pero nasa bahay ka lang. Nasa kwarto ka lang. Then you are good, but you don't have a sense of mission. No sense of purpose. Hindi nagagamit. Parang magandang kotse ka, kaya lang nasa garahe lang. Real goodness is pushed to realize its purpose. Mission with a clear purpose. Anointed and given a mission. It's not about party-party, shopping-shopping, and yet you don't have a sense of purpose, a sense of mission. There is deeper joy in knowing the why of your life. Bakit? Sa mga estudyante nag-aaral, you should know why. You should have a sense of purpose. Kanina po, may kinasal ako, kanina alas 3. Ang ganda ng kasal. Pero sabi ko, sabi nga ni Pope Francis, sabi niya, marriage. Weddings are not only about beautiful dresses, wonderful pictures, and a beautiful dinner. But weddings is about the launching of a mission of the couple. That they launch to a mission together. And that is a source of deep sense of rejoicing. You can own everything, but if you don't have sense of mission for others beyond yourself, then I think there is no sense of rejoicing. Pwede mo naman sabihin, Father, yung mission ko, na-realize ko na eh. Retired na ako, tapos na yung mga bata, nag-aral na silang lahat, may pamilya na sila, tapos na yung mission ko. That is not true. Even in planning, may tinatawag silang re-articulation of our mission. You can re-articulate your mission na rin. Nag-retire ka na. Mission accomplished. But you can still say, what's next? Then you can see a higher level of an articulation of your new mission in life. This time, ang mission mo, hindi na sa mga anak mo na lang, hindi na sa mga apo mo na lang, hindi na sa mga poder mo na lang. It goes beyond. Sabi nga nung narinig ko, charity begins at home, but it should not end at home. It should go beyond. And that is missioning. And I feel people with sense of mission are people with great joy in their life. Hindi nga sila masaya, tumatawa araw-araw, pero malalim ang kanilang kaligayahan. Dahil alam nila, ang buhay nila, hindi sayang. Ikalawa po, let us look at Paul. What is the source of the happiness or joy of Paul? Rejoicing in terms of being grateful in Thessalonians. Sabi po ni St. Paul, brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks. For this is the will of God for you in Jesus Christ. Look at that. In all circumstances, give thanks. Father, kahit na may sakit ako, yes. Kasi buhay ka pa eh. Kahit na wala lang ako, oh, yes. When you always find reason to be grateful in all circumstances, I tell you, you will be one of the most grateful or most joyful person. You don't have to wait for the ideal situation. It may never happen. May nakawalto po akong may sakit na mga ako. Yung sakit niya, kamukha ko po, na stroke. Ang sinalubong niya sa akin, Father, kailan kaya ako magiging 100% recovered? Di ba po, pag na-stroke ka, sometimes you will not be the same as it was before. You will always have your limitation. Ang tanong niya sa akin, kailan kaya babalik yung dati? I do not know. Sabi ko, I do not know. But if you have all the reasons to be grateful, we are still alive. And we survive. We are still up and about. We are living a life. Rejoice. All the time. Ang kaligayahan ni Pablo ay nasa kanyang pasasalamat. Naniniwala ko po, the grateful will always be joyful. And the grateful will always find, will be a joyful giver. I repeat, ang tao mapagpasalamat ay ang tao mas malalim ang kaligayahan. At ang tao mapagpasalamat, they are always joyful givers. Kasi they are already happy with what they are. They are joyful. Pinapasalamat kung ano ang mayroon. You can have everything. But if you are not still grateful for what you already have, maybe you will still be living a miserable life. Pwede? Pwede. May kilala ba kayong mas mayaman sa inyo, pero hindi naman masaya? Pwede. Naalala ko yung isang inupento ng kaibigan kong pare. Nagipag-immersion daw sila sa napakahirap na pamilya. Nung nasa labahay po sila ng isang mahirap na pamilya, nag-apologize daw yung tatay, mahirap sila. Wala silang aircon, wala silang TV, wala silang rent. Pero silang malapit na tubig, may yelo. Sabi po ng tatay, pasensya na po ngayon, wala kaming TV, wala kaming aircon, wala kaming maayos na bahay ng malaki. Ang mayroon lang po namin ay isa't isa. Wow! Sinabi niya, I'm sorry, we don't have everything. We don't have facilities at home. We only have each other. Sa palagay niyo, hindi pa ba masaya yung tao na? Yes. You can have everything, but you have nobody. You have an empty room, an empty house. We have each other. And that is our basic thanksgiving. You have good friends. You have family. You have people who care for you. Rejoice. Material things can give you happiness, but deep relationship gives us deep sense of joy. Lastly, there is rejoicing in identifying ourselves truly for who we are and who we are now. There is rejoicing in identity. This is the gospel. Ang gospel, napakahirap ng tanong na dyan. Who are you? Are you Elijah? Are you the prophet? Are you the one? He said, I am not. I am not the Messiah. I am not Elijah. And I am not a prophet. Who are you? Who are you? I am the voice. I am the voice in the wilderness. I am here calling for us to prepare for the coming of somebody greater than I am. Look at the identity of John. He's so confident. It takes a lot of confidence to say, I am not. Hindi ako yan. Nagkakamali po ako yun. Hindi po ako yan. Because in that way, that sense of confidence brings deep sense of rejoicing. You know why? Ang tao confident sa sarili at alam niya sino siya, sino hindi siya. They don't have to be insecure. They don't have to feel unworthy or negative sense of self. You don't have to compare yourself with others. There are no insecurities. Ang tawag kung isa dyan, identity crisis, di ba? Mayroon kang anabing crisis. Mayroon crisis sa relationship. Mga crisis yan. Pero mayroon din pala identity crisis. When you are not happy, when you are not settled, when you do not accept who you are and who you are not. John shows us the way to real rejoicing. To simply be grateful and simply be joyful for who we are now and who we are. Ito po ang ating mabuting balita. Sabi na ni John, I am not the Christ, I am not the Savior. We do not have to be another person. I pray that after this Mass, uwi tayo maligayang sa buhay. Then we can really say, maligayang Pasko at maligayang bagong taon. Because truly we have that sense of rejoicing that we celebrate this third Sunday of Advent. Are you a joyful person? I'm not asking, are you happy? Nasa sa'yo na yun. But are you really joyful in terms of your mission? In terms of your sense of gratitude? And even in terms of your identity for who you are? Are you confident about your identity? Are you grateful and thankful? And do you have a clear purpose in life? Even how humble it may be, rejoice. Kanina po, ang ganda-ganda ng opening song namin. Can we sing our opening song as our closing to our reflection? And in this way, we will surely say, rejoice, rejoice, O Israel, for you shall come, our Savior, our Emmanuel. Pwede po tayong kumanta as an ending? Attorney, can you lead us?
Thank you.